this is a serious problem, and I will go back to what Mark said. I do think that the United States intervened much too late in that whole process. And this is where I go back to what for me is a fairly consistent theme, and that is the lack of a foreign policy, the lack of a coherent foreign policy that is articulately expressed. When we look at the Syria conflict, we saw the president draw a red line, and the red line was overstepped, and then the president seemed to draw back from that. And then the president saying, our goal is to absolutely eliminate ISIS, which I think is a silly goal because we can't actually achieve the absolute elimination of ISIS. I don't think we have a coherent foreign policy in the region. And I feel as though there's a bubble around the president, and the kinds of advice he is getting is not conducive to him developing any kind of coherent foreign policy. And so it seems to be fits and starts, and we're going to try this, and then we're going to try this. Situation in Afghanistan hasn't gotten any better. The Taliban has taken over some places that were previously held by the United States. ISIS continues to move about in Iraq. So my recommendation to the administration would actually be to take a step back, to think coherently about what our goals are in the region, what it is we can reasonably accomplish, what kinds of resources we can reasonably devote to the situation, and make some decisions there. The best we might be able to do is contain ISIS. The best we might be able to do is recognize that Iraq will fall apart, that there may be a Sunni part of Iraq, there may be a Shia part of Iraq, and there will be a Kurdish state or something like that. And I feel as though we're trying to redraw all the boundaries that existed and put the genie back in the bottle, and that may not be possible. Maybe it is, but I think because there's a lack of coherence and a lack of consistency in how we view the problem, that we're coming up with those kinds of non-solutions.
Mark Lagon, the lack of coherency, in your view, with respect to foreign policy, notwithstanding a couple of these dramatic...
I agree with my friend Tony about the lack of coherence. I worry about the policy becoming too singularly focused on ISIS now. Tony has written a very thought-provoking essay in our book, Human Dignity and the Future of Global Institutions, about terrorism and counterterrorism. I think there are three points worth making here. One, as recently the Senate Intelligence Committee put out a report about a brutal treatment of detainees by the United States. The United States needs to be an example, and it creates more terrorists than it eliminates by overzealous, cruel and inhuman counterterrorism policy. Secondly, the sheer brutality, the love of pain being inflicted that one sees with ISIS reminds us that terrorism is a threat to human dignity. It's a threat to human rights. It's not just the responsibility of those who are fighting terrorism to respect human rights, but it's at heart a problem there. Final point, it's a mistake for the United States to tell autocratic governments in the Middle East that they have carte blanche to fight terrorists and not reform. Those terrorists are only egged on by autocracies that are rigid, that are fragile. We need to press states to change. When we tell Bahrain that we don't mind, that it cracks down on civil society and gets Saudi help to do that, we're doing the worst thing for U.S. interest, both on fighting terrorism and promoting stability and human rights.